I would say that most people probably buy a GoPro to shoot videos. It took me some time to realize that the GoPro is also a great tool for taking interesting photos that can be different from a typical smartphone photo. In this video, I will show you what to consider when taking photos with your GoPro, I will show you a few tips and tricks on how to improve the quality of your photos, I will also explain my camera settings, and finally, I will show you how I personally edit my photos. And in case you are new here, my name is Werner, I live in the Italian Alps, and on this channel you will find tutorials on the topics GoPro, filmmaking, photography, and of course you will find many beautiful images of landscapes. Consider subscribing if you're interested in these topics and have fun with this video. If you want to get the best out of a camera, you should be aware of its special properties and its strengths and weaknesses. This is especially true for a GoPro. That's why I would like to talk briefly about the special properties of the GoPro and what effects they have on photography. The GoPro has a fisheye lens with a focal length of about 60 mm, so it has a lens with an extremely wide field of view. This has advantages and disadvantages. Such a lens is very suitable for certain situations, but for other situations it is rather less suitable. Of course, this field of view is very suitable if you want to include a lot of information in your image, for example when taking landscapes or cityscapes. But the wide-angle lens has another strength, and that is that it is great to convey spatial depth. Objects in the foreground appear large and objects in the background relatively small, so they appear very distant. This gives a good spatial impression and the image may look more vivid. However, there is also a negative effect associated with this property, and that is that the wide angle leads to distortions. This is further emphasized by the fisheye character of the GoPro lens. The distortion causes objects to curve inwards towards the center of the frame. The distortion becomes stronger the further away the object is from the center of the frame and the closer it is to the edge. Especially with classic portrait shots, these distortions lead to unpleasant results. The nose, for example, looks bigger than you might want it to be. Therefore, the GoPro is not really suitable for classic portrait shots or shots where straight lines are important, such as architectural shots, which should be realistic. With the help of different settings, you can reduce the distortions. But this will result in a strong crop and a special wide angle will be partly lost. A certain amount of distortion also remains when you shoot your images with the field of view linear, for example. You can also reduce the obvious distortions by placing your object, perhaps a person, in the center of the frame or by placing the horizon in the center of the frame. Apart from the special characteristics of the lens, we should take a quick look at the sensor. The GoPro has a rather small sensor that's about the size of a sensor of a good smartphone camera. This also affects the photos you can take with it. The small sensor combined with the wide-angle lens means that more or less all areas of the image are in focus. The focus is also fixed at infinity. This also has advantages and disadvantages. You don't have to worry about correct focusing and you can take a few photos very quickly. However, you don't have the possibility to create a blurred background to emphasize objects in the foreground. There will always be everything in focus. You should be aware of this when composing your images, because this can quickly lead to the image looking overloaded. On the other hand, this can be very useful for certain shots, such as environmental portraits, where you take a photo of a person in a special environment, for example in the case of travel pictures. But the small sensor also has another decisive disadvantage. It captures relatively little light and is therefore not very suitable for taking pictures in low light conditions. Although the GoPro has a mode for night shots that is supposed to improve the quality of the photos in low light conditions, even this night mode can't work wonders. Personally, I would not specifically recommend the GoPro for this type of shots. Now let's look at some tips and tricks on how to take good and interesting photos with your GoPro. First, I would like to encourage you to use the special qualities of the GoPro I just discussed to your advantage. Especially with the very wide fisheye lens, you can take very creative photos that are clearly different from a typical smartphone photo and thus have something special. As already mentioned, the fisheye lens creates curved lines. It is therefore well suited for taking pictures of rounded shapes or if you take photos pointing the GoPro upwards, for example. Even though I said that the GoPro is not really suitable for classic portraits, you can still use it to take interesting creative pictures of people. As I said, be careful not to place the person at the edges to avoid extreme distortion. And think about how you can use your GoPro to create spatial depth, for example to show the great and expansive nature. Be aware that objects in the foreground can be very dominant. Don't forget this if your goal is mainly to capture the landscape in the background. A second tip I would like to give you today is that you should use another strength of the GoPro to take special and creative photos, and I refer to the huge selection of mounts. There is an infinite number of mounts, tripods and poles for the GoPro. These can not only help you to shoot good videos, but also interesting photos. For example, you can capture unusual perspectives with a pole, which might be difficult to achieve with another camera. The pole is also suitable for selfies, where you can also capture a lot of the scenery. With a pole, you can even create group selfies. If you hold the pole sideways, you can also take vertical self-portraits, which might be more suitable for your Instagram account. Or with a suction cup mount, you might be able to attach your GoPro to a car and take spectacular pictures while driving. But these are all just examples. The large number of mounts for the GoPro is certainly one of the great strengths of this camera. That's why you should consider using it for photos as well. For all mounts and accessories I use myself, I have put links in the video description. Of course, you should also remember that the GoPro as an action camera is not only suitable for action videos, but also for action photography or simply for photos of fast movements. For this purpose, you will find the burst mode in the photo mode, with which you can take up to 10 images per second. This way, you can capture the perfect moment even during fast-paced activities. And of course, the relatively shockproof and waterproof body also allows you to take photos in situations where you might not necessarily want to use your smartphone or a larger camera. When you take pictures in difficult lighting conditions, that is in situations with very bright and very dark areas in the same frame, the bright areas often burn out and lack detail. You should avoid this in any case, because such a photo will never look really good. There are a number of ways to fix this problem. You can set the exposure completely manually, you can use the HDR mode, which we will talk about in a moment, and you can use the camera's exposure control. To do this, tap with your finger on a brighter area on the LCD screen. A white square will appear, and the camera will automatically adjust exposure to that area. If you tap on the square again, a small lock will appear. If you confirm, you can fix the exposure in this way. The image may look a little dark. However, a photo file contains much more information than a frame of a video file. Therefore, as you will see later in this video, you can brighten up dark areas very well in post. Before I show you how I edit my photos, I would like to show you my settings. Basically, in photo mode, you can choose between standard, HDR, super photo and RAW. I don't want to go into detail about these settings today, as I have already made a very detailed video on this topic. In general, I just want to tell you that in standard mode, a simple JPEG file is created. In HDR mode, several exposures are overlaid to increase the dynamic range. That means to get more details in the very dark and the very bright areas of the picture. In super photo mode, the camera autonomously applies different processing methods depending on the situation. Usually, this gives the image more clarity and contrast and thus a little more punch. This is especially useful if you don't want to edit your photos and maybe want to upload them immediately to your smartphone and Instagram. Personally, I usually use the RAW mode. Here the camera creates a file in the so-called GPR format, in addition to the usual JPEG file. Normally such RAW files contain much more information than JPEG files, because JPEG is a highly compressed format. Therefore, RAW files are normally much better suited for editing. However, it is a fact that the GoPro RAW files are only about the same size as the JPEG files. So I doubt that files in the GPR format contain much more information than a JPEG file. However, I have found that GPR files are less processed than JPEG files that have already undergone certain processing steps by the camera. For this reason, I still prefer these files for further editing, because the processing steps contained in the JPEG files are irreversible. But the GPR format has a decisive disadvantage. It can only be opened and edited with software by Adobe, thus with Lightroom or Camera Raw. This is software that is more suitable for professionals due to its subscription model. As an alternative for editing your photos, you could take a look at Luminar, for example. But there you can only edit the JPEG files, which in my opinion is not such a serious problem for the mentioned reasons. No matter what you decide to do, if you want to take the quality of your photos to a higher level, you have to learn how to edit a photo properly. Today, I would like to show you how I edit my photos in Lightroom. The principles are the same in the other programs like Luminar. After I have imported my photo, I first take care of the exposure. I look at whether the photo should be a little brighter or darker for a better result. Then I usually reduce the highlights to bring back details in the bright areas. The shadows are increased a bit to get more details in the darker areas. Please note that this is not supposed to be a complete Lightroom or editing tutorial. I just want to show you some of the possibilities that such a software offers. Mostly, I increase the clarity and look at the results. With clarity, you can give the image a little more punch. With landscapes, this can give the photo more dramatic effect. Then I deal with the colors. I check the white balance and see if I want to make the picture a little warmer or cooler. Using the so-called HSL sliders, you can then edit the colors individually. You can change the hue, the saturation of the individual colors and also their luminance. Here I mainly edit the colors that are dominant in the picture. Then I often use radial filters or gradient filters and selectively edit individual areas of the image, especially concerning the exposure of these areas. And as you can see, we made our picture much more interesting with a few clicks. There are many other options in this software. Today I mainly wanted to show you that for better photos it is very important to spend some time with an image editing software. Finally, I would like to summarize the most important statements of this video in a few tips. Be aware of the strengths and weaknesses of your GoPro and use the special qualities of the wide-angle fisheye lens to your advantage. Use also the possibilities of the many mounts and the shock and waterproof body for more interesting photos. Avoid burning out areas of the image that are too bright. You can use the exposure control to achieve this easily and quickly. If you want to significantly improve your photos, you will also need to learn about editing your images. There are many good programs for this purpose. The important thing is that you learn how to use one of them properly. And that's it for today. If the video was interesting for you, give me a like as feedback, and see you next time.